I have a pair of scissors because I want to talk about a piece of maths called the fold and cut theorem. It's one of those things in maths where they just name it what it is. This first came to my attention when I was trying to cut a square hole in a piece of paper. So I, like, my first instinct as a person who cuts holes in paper was to jab a hole and then cut around the edge of the square. But I thought, okay, maybe there's an easier way to do this. And kind of my mathematical brain kicked in and I realized that if I fold this in half like that, I can just cut along those three edges. Okay, I've roughly approximated the hole I was originally trying to draw. There's a square hole. And I guess, like, the mathematician in me was like, can I do that more easily? Can I make this more efficient? So what I thought then was, if I fold this twice, so I make the first fold the same, and then fold that at 90 degrees to that, I now have this bit of line, and I can now cut two cuts like that, and I'll end up with my square hole.
Two cuts.
It's two cuts. It's less than three cuts. It's more efficient. But of course, you want to optimize this. So, you know, your mathematically efficient way of doing this for just a square is to start off with one fold in half, a second fold like that, and then your third fold is a diagonal fold through that corner. So as long as you get all of those kind of folds exactly right and the lines that you're cutting along are all lying on top of each other, you can now cut out the entire square, the whole shape, with just one straight cut. Like that. And this is the moment of truth, the bit where you don't really believe what you've done has worked. But it turns out a square is pretty much the easiest one to do. It is efficient and it's one straight cut. And this kind of idea, like I went to the pub, as you do when you've discovered a nice thing. And I was like, I wonder if this is a thing you can do in general. I wonder what shapes you can cut out with one cut. And a friend of mine who was in the pub said, isn't that a theorem? As all mathematicians will tend to do, I went and looked up that. It is a theorem. It's called the fold and cut theorem. And it says that any shape whose edges are all made up of straight lines can be cut out with one cut if you're prepared to fold the bit of paper. Which is just insane. And I love this. It was proved by a guy called Eric Demain and the team of other researchers. They've proved that it is possible to cut out any straight line edge shape, even if it's got more than one bit to it, even if it's got a hole in the middle, you can make one cut and cut out the whole thing. There are various examples of this throughout history. So Harry Houdini, the magician, used to apparently do a star with one cut as part of his magic show. And it is sufficiently impressive to go in a Houdini magic show, it turns out. So I've looked that up and I've figured out how to do that. So it's in half first. It's in half that way and in half that way to get a cross shape. And then the fold is there. And in theory, that should give you 108 degrees-ish. You can then fold that one in half. Fold that back and fold that, and you can tell you've done it right because that's the same size as that-ish. And there's actually a nice little story behind this, because apparently when America was founded in the 1770s, they needed a flag and they went to see a seamstress called Betsy Ross. I don't know if it's a true story. It could be one of these made-up stories that George Washington walks into a fabric shop and was like, I'm going to need a lot of stars cutting out. And she had a piece of fabric and she just grabbed it and folded it up like this. And she did the one cut. So it's from there, kind of up that way. And she unfolded this and showed George Washington that she'd cut out a perfect five-pointed star with just one cut. And the story goes that he was like, oh, well, you can make all the flags then. And she then had like work for life making all of the American flags. And at that stage, there were only like a few stars on the flag. They kept updating it and adding more stars, so she had to remake all the flags. So it was quite a decent amount of work just because she happened to know this little trick. And I love that. I love that. The most impressive thing for me is that not only have you got a star, you've also got a piece of paper with a star-shaped hole in it. That's a five-pointed star. That's my favourite bit, is that you get the opposite thing as well, because it is just that line that's cut, it's nothing else. The next thing in the paper that they list in kind of things that they've seen was that someone had once seen an example of someone who could cut out any letter of the alphabet on demand. And I looked this up and tried to find it, and I couldn't find anyone who did this. I was like, right, well, that's, I'm going to do that. I'm going to figure out how to do every letter of the alphabet. And it turns out it's not even just a cool thing to be able to do. It's actually a really fun thing to work out. So you start with these simple letters like L, because they're quite easy. That's just one kind of diagonal fold, and then you need to make the ends. You can do things like O, as long as you don't mind it being quite square. And then things gradually get more and more difficult. And the easier ones tend to be quite symmetrical. So T is quite easy. S is not easy. S is a bit of a nightmare, but it is possible. So I've worked out a fold pattern for every letter of the alphabet. Having done this, I then got an email from someone saying, I've just found this PDF with a fold pattern for every letter of the alphabet. I was like, oh, what? That already existed. Oh, well, never mind. But it, you know, the system that I've worked out, I'm happy with. It's slightly different in places. But you know, there are these things out there, but it is more fun to work it out yourself. Well, we've got A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, and K, and then L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Okay. That's an A. That is B. That's C. That is D. E. That one's F. G. That's the closest I can get to G without any curves. Little H. There's I. J. So of course is my initial, K. That is completely different from J. That's L. Okay, that one is M. That is, there's no way I'll get this the right way around. Is that the right way around?
Yeah.
N. O. It's P, it's good enough. It's tiny, but it's a Q. That's R.
Nice.
Bit of a nightmare, that one. Oh, it's worked.
Well done.
S. Yep. Slightly funky T. U. Slightly 70s looking V. So that's W. X. It's quite a fun one to work out. So I'm very happy. That's a Y. It's looking good. It's looking good from there, isn't it? So that's a Z. Like, working out how to fold that is such a mathematical thing to do. Like, it's the type of thinking that mathematicians use can be applied to so many situations, and this is exactly one of them. But this is an example of something which also mathematicians have properly used, you know, mathematical analysis on, and they've proved a thing about it, which is, you know, for me, that's what maths is about. It's not about calculating things, it's about proving things, and it's about understanding how the universe works. And it turns out that in this universe, one cut suffices.
We'd like to thank lynda.com for supporting this video. Now, Lynda's great. They have a huge range of video courses. I was actually going through the catalogue earlier and came across some great ones about how to use typefaces and typography. This is something I find really interesting. This one here is called The 33 Laws of Typography, and it's gone right to the top of my watch list. I'll be having a look at that one soon, I think. But whatever it is you want to learn, whether it's something creative, techie, maybe just getting better at business, Lynda will have something for you. There's over 3,000 video courses and 100,000 tutorials in the vault. You can sign up now for a free 10-day trial. That's unlimited access to all those videos by going to lynda.com/numberphile or clicking on the link in the description. That's Lynda, lynda.com/numberphile. Give it a try, and our thanks to Lynda for supporting Numberphile.
I did a show at Cheltenham a couple of years ago, and one of the things that I did in it was, as the challenge, like to pick a person in the audience, ask them what their name was, and then cut out that word while explaining the maths behind this. It was brilliant. I asked for a four-letter word. Has anyone got a four-letter name? And this guy shouted his name, and I can't remember what it was, but it was five letters. And everyone was like, mate, that's five letters. And it was just a gift. It was hilarious.